I feel so excited about tonight, and I can't wait for everybody to see as we unveil.
Honestly, I don't know what to expect. I'm excited, I'm anxious, but I'm just hoping tonight brings me nothing but the rest.
I've gotten a lot of positive energy from my friends and family, so I'm feeling very positive tonight. And I'm going to be using one trick Miss Jocelyn taught us at finishing school. That is, anytime you're in front of an audience, look above your foreheads.
Miss Malaika Ghana, proudly brought to you by UB Hair Relaxer, Glam's Makeup, Infinix, Awake Mineral Water, Carnival Liqueur, GTP, Turmeric Hotel, Kenya Airways, TCL Electronics, and GH1 TV, and supported by Taxify, Gold Coast Restaurant, Henry's Inn, Kaya Tours, Papa's Pizza, Barber Photos, and Volta Serene Hotel.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to the grand launch of the 2018 edition of Miss Malaika Ghana. Well, after tonight, the journey towards 16 ladies becoming better versions of themselves and ultimately finding that one lady who will be crowned Miss Malaika Ghana 2018 officially begins. Well, my name is Anita Ekia Akofo. Well, quickly, let me say a big thank you to our amazing sponsors who make the show possible. Well, special thanks going out to UB Hair Relaxer, Glam's Makeup, Infinix, Awake Mineral Water, Carnival Liqueur, GTP, Turmeric Hotel, Kenya Airways, Japan Motors, TCL Electronics, GH1 Television, and Wisconsin University.
Well, of course, special thanks going out to Taxify, Kaya Tours, City Escape Hotels, Baobab Photos, Gold Coast Restaurants, Henry's Inn, Papa's Pizza, Oasis Pool and Lounge, where the launch is happening, and yes, Club Onyx as well.
Well, and just in case you're wondering where we are, Bella, do you want to tell them?
Well, we're in our secret white room here at Club Onyx, where we'll be interacting with our top 16 delegates before you get to meet them officially. And I'm sure that you're looking forward to that interaction, because you might be able to decide which of the 16 delegates you'd want to start supporting from tonight. So I guess that at this point, I will be interacting with them, and I guess they'll meet you on stage.
Exactly. So okay, I'll have to take leave of you, and I wish you all the best. I hope you enjoy the night.
Thank you. You too, and you look lovely, by the
you
way.
You too, by the way.
Yes.
Another one.
What does glam mean to me?
What does glam mean to me?
Burned out cremation, burned up. Make it cream, yeah, Wu-Tang. Throw that ass back, bouquet.
Call me gorgeous.
I could tell you gone off the doors.
Sexy.
Mama, why would you say? You talking to me like your new babe.
Beautiful.
Like you trying to do things. Now that pipe got her running like she Usain, baby.
Glamorous.
In it, ooh, touche, baby. I'm carrying that water, Bobby Boucher, baby. And you know I'ma slaughter like I'm Jason.
Another one.
Africa, it's amazing and it's ours. So why not get out there and explore it with Kenya Airways? We crisscross this incredible continent over 500 times a week, offering unrivaled connections to over 40 destinations via our world-class hub in Nairobi. There's so much more to see. Discover Africa with Kenya Airways, the pride of Africa.
Damn, fresh on the beat.
is where the love, she keeps me connected to. The ones I love the most, she's always there too, yeah. Capture the perfect moment, she's picture perfect. She entertained me, always, always. She can go for 3 days, no recharge, no recharge.
Guy, now who be this babe?
Babe, okay. Now my Infinix Note 5 had a freestyle for. Okay, Google. Who is Davido?
According to Wikipedia, is a Nigerian singer, songwriter, and record producer.
Infinix, the future is now.
Delicious meals served to our delegates courtesy Gold Coast Restaurant, Henry's Inn, and Papa's Pizza. Many thanks to our glam team designers, Mamey Clothing, Ajua Yeboah Clothing, Etruba Couture, September by Awulana, Sherry Brown Couture, Malbe Couture, Meros by Afra K, Akofa's Wardrobe, Sante's Trend, African Novelty, Adol's Emporium, Luxoka.
Good evening and welcome to the launch of Miss Malaika Ghana 2018. Thank you so much for joining us here at the Oasis Lounge right here in Cantonment. Well, if you have been watching Miss Malaika 2018 since it started the past few weeks, you know what has been happening. But if you haven't, let me take you through the journey so far. Well, on the 13th of July, lots of ladies, over 300 ladies, were at the Tomek Hotel to be auditioned for this year's Miss Malaika Ghana. At the end of the day, 100 ladies made it to the semi-final stage, and over 26 ladies also proceeded to the finishing school. At the end of last week's episode, we saw our 16 ladies who made it after the fun, the interactions, the bonding. Well, 10 had to say goodbye, and tonight we have our 16 beautiful, intelligent, eloquent ladies who will be unveiled very soon. But before we get to that, let me say a big thank you to our bloggers who keep us trending on social media. We have AmayaDebra.com, we have NkonkonSaGH, Cool Peeps Entertainment, Tayman GH, Pulse GH, Event Lab, and GH Kweku. Well, my name is Anita Ekuyakofo. I'm your host for tonight. And my co-host, Brella Mundi, is obviously in there somewhere with our beautiful, eloquent ladies. So let's move straight over to our two first delegates as Bella interacts with them.
All right, so here I am in the white room, and I'm seated with two of our delegates. And first up, she was the first person that was announced, you know, as taking her spot in the top 16. She is Libby. And next to her, I have Nana Amma. And they look so lovely, 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 lovely. Now, Libby's outfit has been designed by Akofa's Wardrobe, with makeup by Glance Makeup and faces by Kes, and her hair by Chriselle Saloon, beat by Beatbox GH. And Nanama has been styled by Meros by Afra K, also makeup by Glam's Makeup, and hair by Pretty by Oyinka, beads by Beatbox GH. Y'all are okay, right?
Yes.
Okay, Libby, I have a question for you. And your question is, what was your biggest fear coming into the pageant? Have you overcome it, and how?
Okay, until now, I thought I was a quiet and shy person. Mm-hmm. And I feared I would be robbed of my confidence when I have to face people to speak. But this pageant has uncovered a me I didn't know existed, and I'm really loving it.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm now more outspoken, okay, bold, and outgoing.
That's nice.
And yeah, I was able to achieve this by simply facing my fears.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And making sure it's subject to me.
Okay.
And also bearing in mind that if I don't conquer it today, I'm definitely going to face it another day.
Definitely.
So, yeah.
And I wish you the very best of
luck.
Thank you. Nanama, do you think beauty pageants are worth it? Are they, you know, should people invest in it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I believe beauty pageants has got enormous benefits, of which you, Bella, here is one of it, because it actually helps young ladies to know their passion and find out what they are best at and work at it. And it also helps them to embark on social outreach, which actually impacts a whole lot on our society. And not to talk of portraying our country through the eye of tourism to the world. We have, like, what you're wearing is very pretty.
Thank you.
And that was made by a fashion designer.
Yes.
So in a sense, it's actually putting the fashion industry and the entertainment industry out there.
Okay.
So I believe most people should come into it and have fun.
Certainly. Yeah. And well, that's why you're watching and supporting. And I believe that one of these two ladies, or both of them, could be your favorite. I'm introducing to you our first two delegates who have made it into Miss Malaika Ghana 2016, Libby and Nanama. They'll take their spot on stage with Anita. all the very best.
Thank you.
All right, here you go.
All right, Bella, so that was Nanama and Libby. Who do you have for us next? I'm itching to know who they are.
All right, and yes, back in the little room, we have Gloria and Anne, also looking ravishing as always. And that's the good thing about Miss Malaika Ghana. We select the very best. Ladies, you're welcome. Gloria, I know that definitely when you're joining a pageant, there's something you want to learn from it. People have various reasons for joining. If it should end today, what's that one thing that you take out of this pageant?
One thing I would want to learn from this pageant is good influencing abilities.
Okay.
Because I'm very passionate about being an advocate for disabled people.
All right.
And advocacy requires influence.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the principal thing I would want and I would need if I want to take on and lead a disabled society.
Certainly, and I hope that you see yourself through it and help as many people as possible. And you look beautiful as well. And I'm sure that, you know, as well, you have a lot to learn from it. And there are a lot of people looking up to you, hoping that you'll make it to the very top. Who's that one person you wouldn't want to disappoint?
I'd say my father.
Okay, why him?
Because I want to make sure I do my best. I want to win, get the crown. I want to impart lives, make a positive difference to the world. This I know will make him very proud.
Okay.
Yes, because he doesn't like beauty pageants. He has a negative perception, which I want to change.
Wow.
Yeah, I want to prove to him that beauty pageants are positive things. Like, it will rather make me a better person. I want to make
certainly.
Him proud.
And well, Daddy, we hope that you keep watching and supporting your little girl, because you'll see so many positive things happen in her life. And to all parents as well, this is what Miss Malaika Ghana is about. I wish you two the very best of luck, Gloria and Anne. Over to you, Anita. My two delegates will be joining you on stage.
Well, four ladies down, 12 more to go. That means we have a lot of ladies coming up. Well, Bella, back to you.
All right, yes, and back into the white room with Olivia and Rosetta, all part of our top 16 delegates, beautifully styled by some of the best designers in town. Ladies, you're welcome. And you look lovely, by the way.
Thank you.
Why is it important for a queen to take up a project after she's crowned? Because people would usually expect that, you know, all you get is the car, the crown, live the luxurious life, and just be queen. But with Miss Malaika, we think it's prudent for a queen to take up a, you know, a project. Why is it that important for you?
Okay, I think it's very important for a queen to take up on projects because there's a misconceptions about beauty queens
yeah.
in general, in quotes, beauty without brain. So when I think when one is given this opportunity, the queen is supposed to utilize it or to take up on a worthy cause.
Mm-hmm.
Some people think being a queen is to be served.
Yes.
And I totally disagree with that because I feel being a queen is a calling to serve. Like you are rather serving. So you're becoming like a voice to the voiceless and a representative of the people.
Yes.
So in general, I think that when you're given this opportunity, it should be like a green light, sort of like a green light and a ginger moment
mm-hmm.
for you to take up on so many projects, not just to change the society, but also to bring growth to the country at large.
Certainly. Rosetta, do you have any competition?
Personally, I believe that moving my focus from direct competition and comparison
mm-hmm.
with the other ladies, I believe that will go a long way to propel me to be better.
Okay. So all the best. You can go on stage now and show yourselves to the world.
All right, it keeps getting interesting as you get to find out what the ladies think about some issues and also their perspectives on life. So Bella, back to you. Who are our next delegates?
All right, and I have Della and Mifia, well, joining me right now. How are you feeling? Nervous, huh? Or you're relaxed?
Fine.
You're fine.
Yeah.
Okay, Della, there's always an assigned project for every queen or every winner. But aside that, if you have to take on another project, what would it be?
Knowing that there are a lot of young people coming out with businesses and innovative ideas and need support, I will throw my support through social media marketing.
Okay.
If I become the Miss Malaika Queen, I will support them through social media hype. Then if there is any other recommendations I have to make to people just to grow their businesses and put their businesses onto the radar so it progresses.
So you'll be supporting entrepreneurs,
yes,
and helping people to grow their businesses,
yes,
and all,
yes,
that. Yeah. Yeah. How are you as well? Good?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What's one negative perception you've had about Miss Malaika or about beauty pageants in general, and has it been debunked?
Okay. Yes, it has been debunked.
Okay.
Before I took the bold step, or before I embarked on this Miss Malaika journey, I used to have this perception that Miss Malaika is about whom you know.
Mm.
But right now, I'm seated here, I didn't know anybody, and I believe I was picked for my personality and who I am, not whom I knew.
Okay.
Yeah.
And well, I hope that it runs through, because that's what it's about. We're looking forward to you showing us the very best of yourself. Okay. Anita, we're coming back to you with Della and Ifya.
Well, of course, we have to go back to Bella Mundi in the little white room to give us more of our ladies. Bella, back to you.
All right. So, yes, I'm here with Geza, and, of course, Ambriah, also looking astonishing tonight. And they have made it into the top 16. So, Geza, there's a car to be won. There's some cash, there's a crown, and then there's a scholarship. Which one are you looking out for the most?
Definitely the crown.
Definitely the crown. Tell me why.
Well, I believe it's going to help me as an individual, and it's also going to help me have an influence,
okay,
on the society, and also create a great impact in the society. And it's going to help me meet people of authority,
yeah,
and also people who are key influencers to the growth of the society of
Ghana. Certainly. Yeah. Imagine the crown is on your head and you're giving us a wave. How is it going to be? All the best. Ambriah, you left a lot behind to take part in Miss Malaika Ghana. You lived in the States and had to let go of almost everything to come down here. So what's that one thing that you miss the most?
I would say my younger sisters.
Okay.
Because I love them so much. I'm always with them. I take them shopping with me. And originally they were supposed to come, and unfortunately they weren't able to come.
Aww.
So I had to decide to, you know, take that leap of faith and realize that I had a stronger calling in coming and being able to connect more with my traditions, more,
mm-hmm,
than I could back in the States, being,
okay,
able to connect more with my family. And it really makes me so much more calmer to know that I'm being a role model for them. I'm showing them that they can do anything that they want to do.
Certainly.
And that they can achieve their dreams, and also other young girls out there too. So
can achieve your dreams. And let's say you win, maybe you can get some more money and you'd have a car so you could drive them around town and shop,
yes,
for them even more, right?
Okay.
Well, all the best to both of you, by the way. And I know it's nerve-wracking sometimes, but relax and have a lot of fun, okay? All right, so ladies and gentlemen, we have Geza and we have Ambriah, who will be joining Anita on stage right now.
Water gives life. Water is life. Enjoy the pure, refreshing taste of Awake purified drinking water, which comes in a uniquely designed bottle with a lemon green tap. Water is your perfect way to stay hydrated. And remember, for every bottle you buy, an amount will be donated to the National Cardiothoracic Center, Ghana. Awake purified drinking water. One for life.
For bulk purchase, contact 0262-351-251.
What do you look out for when checking into a hotel? Cleanliness, amenities, food, safety, and more. Turmeric Hotel has it all covered. From our luxurious rooms to our fine dining restaurants, swimming pool, fitness center, business center, conference, and more. At Turmeric Hotel, we understand hospitality and we go the whole nine yards. Call reservations today on 0302-510-307, 0302-510-382 or info@turmerichotel.com. Locate us at Shiashi Lagos Avenue in East Lagoon. Call us today. We welcome you to an amazing experience. Turmeric Hotel, hospitality redefined.
Many thanks to our glam team makeup artists, Bliss Beauty Lounge, Black Cherry Beauty Lounge, Glitterati Makeup, Adele's Makeup, Efe the Makeup Artist, Posa da Belle, Faces by Kes, Belle Flair.
Well, it looks like we have a lot more of our ladies to go. Yes, a couple more. And I have to go back to Bella Mundi to give us who she has next.
All right, so yes, I have Vanessa Donko and Samira seated next to me. And by the way, special thanks to GTP for the lovely fabrics that you've seen on them. Well, ladies, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Vanessa, I'm hearing you're the youngest.
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 18.
18? Oh my word. Okay. But I mean, as the youngest person in the pageant, I'm sure you've seen all the ladies and you probably think, okay, everybody's older, probably more mature. But what's that one quality that you have that makes you stand out?
Okay, I think the strongest quality that I have as the youngest person is confidence.
Okay.
And I'll say that's because for my age, that is 18 years, there's so many people out there that are actually struggling with self-confidence, especially because coming into adulthood, they haven't had the chance to have that experience, have the people around them that are going to give them the influence.
Mm-hmm.
So I think for me, fortunately, I was able to get into the limelight quite early.
Mm-hmm.
So I had some experiences and some people around me that guided me,
okay,
making me know what I want. And then that has actually given me so much confidence. And I think that can actually lead me to the crown.
Yeah? You want the crown, huh?
I want the crown.
You know you have to work hard for it.
I know.
It's a lot of work.
Yeah.
So you're ready, right?
Yes, I am so ready. Well,
Samira is smiling, but she's not too happy with you. I'm sure in her head she's saying, if only you knew. Yeah. I want the crown so badly. But Samira, I know. During the auditions, I remember you talked about some forms of abuses and, you know, accidents that you experienced. But would you say that all these scars and the experiences that you went through define you as a person?
Honestly, I think it would be unrealistic to say that it has defined me, because I believe that what defines a person is quite complex.
Okay.
I believe that it takes a lot to define someone. However, I won't push away the fact that it has shaped me in certain ways, like my dreams, my aspirations, things I look out for, what makes me happy, are all now based on my experiences.
Okay.
Now I sit here and I want to be the role model for kids who have been through such abuses. I want to be like the limelight for such people. And I think I'm quite confident now and much better, and I'm loving the new.
I must honestly say you're a very strong woman for even opening up to the rest of the world, and so keep it up. And both of you ladies, all the best. Let's see which of you fights for the crown at the end. Yeah? But you look lovely, and so you can go out there and let your friends and family meet you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this point, we have a couple of spots left for some of our delegates, and we have to go back to Bella Mooney to take the rest.
All right, so Evelyn and Jennifer have joined me as well, looking lovely. And I must say thank you again to GTP for the lovely fabrics that you're seeing on our lady. Evelyn, you have a very interesting surname. Nyasemche. It sounds like it has a very deep meaning. You know, I'm thinking, okay, what does this mean? And how do you relate it to life?
My father is not Mr. Nyasemche. Is that what you're thinking?
Your father is not Mr. Nyasemche?
No.
Okay.
From what I've learned so far, I was named after my great grandmother.
Oh.
Yes. Her mother went through a very trying time in her life.
Okay.
And when she was born, she named her Nyasemche.
Okay.
As tough as it may seem, not everyone in your life loves you.
Yeah.
when you're going through your deepest and darkest moments, you wonder where they all are.
Mm-hmm.
They won't be there for you. So my name has taught me to be cautious of how I live my life and the company I keep.
Wow. Yeah. So you have only one friend?
Or no, about four or five.
Only? Yeah. Is there space for me to be your friend as well?
Oh, yes,
you'll be my now. All right, Jennifer, what has been the most challenging thing for you, you know, joining this pageant, and how have you been able to overcome it?
Okay, that would be the loss of my dad.
Aww.
Yes, I lost him a few weeks to the main auditions.
Oh my.
It wasn't easy. And when I found out that the date for the burial was the same date we were going to be finally selected, I had to be at the funeral and I couldn't be here. But by God's grace, the judges gave me a chance.
Yeah.
Because this is actually my third time.
Wow. Yes. The things happen for a reason.
Yes,
you
and they
know
say
that.
Third time's a charm.
So. You know. So who knows? Maybe the crown could be coming on your head. Anyway, so all the best to both of you, and may your father continue to rest in perfect peace. Well, you can go out there and meet your friends and family and fans as well, okay?
All right, Bella, back to you. Who do you have for us?
Final two ladies who will be joining the 14 delegates on stage, rounding up the number to 16. And so Mariam is here along with Vanessa. And they look like Barbie dolls. I don't even know how they were paired, but I think it's just lovely watching them sit here as well. And in fact, ladies, congratulations for coming this far. Mariam, there are a lot of young ladies out there with low self-esteem. You have made it into this pageant. If you have that opportunity to speak to them, what would you say?
I would tell them to build upon their confidence, learn something I didn't do, but I'm learning now.
Okay.
As they're not here yet, I think they should take it upon themselves to try and speak in public, speak in front of their classmates, speak in front of people when they get the chance. And I think that will help them build their confidence. And as time goes on, they will learn to master public speaking and everything related to
definitely
that. Yes.
Vanessa, I'm sure you'd say same to those ladies as well, right? But do you have any project in mind?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
I had to see women die of disease that could be cured and prevented, and that's cervical cancer.
Okay.
So my project would be creating awareness and educating young ladies on how to prevent cervical cancer.
Yeah. And well, October is fast approaching, and so also we'll be focusing on cancer, breast cancer, and some people will be focusing on cervical cancer as well. And so if you are there, I'm sure, you know, Vanessa would advise you to go check and be sure that you're safe. All the best.
Thank you.
Isn't the crowd too big for your head? Don't you want to pass it on to the other ladies?
No.
You hold it?
That's fine.
You hang it?
Yeah?
Yeah,
hold it.
Okay, then go on stage and prove to the world that you deserve that spot, okay?
Alright, at this point we go for a quick commercial break. When we come back, it's still Miss Malaika Ghana 2018, the grand launch right here at Oasis Lounge in Cantonment. We'll be back.
Africa, it's amazing and it's ours. So why not get out there and explore it with Kenya Airways? We crisscross this incredible continent over 500 times a week, offering unrivaled connections to over 40 destinations via our world-class hub in Nairobi. There's so much more to see. Discover Africa with Kenya Airways, the pride of Africa.
Teach.
Together.
It inspires change.
Together.
Share. It inspires warmth. Celebrate. It inspires growth. Innovate. It inspires possibility. Love. It inspires hope. GTP. Forever inspiring. GTP. Timeless.
Better than life.
QCL CSITS UHD TV. Born a legend.
I'm Will Senyo, CEO and co-founder of Impact Hub Accra. Impact Hub Accra is focused on supporting early stage entrepreneurs and innovators with a mix of support services. We run an accelerator program here. We have open co-working spaces, and we help companies attract growth capital. So we have about 1,400 square meters of space, clustering about 250 young people working in different startups. I had a career in both for-profit industry and then a non-profit industry, and I felt and they both quite didn't fit some of the issues I wanted to fix until I found myself finding alternative setups, and the social enterprise kind of paradigm fits a lot of what I believe in, especially fixing big issues in Africa, where you can focus on both generating profit but at the same time also having social and environmental impact. I'd say we've been around for nearly a year, five and a half years. We've seen steady growth from where we started and where we are. Typically, I think we followed a less than typical growth trajectory for businesses like ours. So I'd say we're doing fairly well and constantly growing and hoping to have some exponential growth in the next few years. I think I'm seeing a lot of energy in the sector, and I'm hopeful that as the concept takes root, more and more typical for-profit institutions can take the core tenets of social enterprise and actually have it as core to their own operations, because everyone wins in that sense. I think also non-profit institutions will slowly transition to becoming social enterprises and more sustainable, with more sustainable business models. I'm seeing that transition already happen. The Ghanaian economy doesn't necessarily reward the smartest, it rewards the most resilient. And I hope that most young people understand that resilience is one of the core principles that they have to abide by to be able to thrive in a market that can be really tough. You can't give it a shot a few more months and say, throw your hands up in the air, that doesn't work. You have to iterate, you have to respond to the market stimuli, and you have to make sure that you are built for the long term, not the short term. I know it can be tough, but if there's one thing I've learned, is that resilience is a really big factor in success for social enterprises, at least in our market here in Ghana.
Many thanks to our blogging team, Amael Deborah, Kokonsa GH, Cool Peeps, Entertainment GH, Pulse GH, Event Lab, GH Kweku. Many thanks to our media partners, Plus FM, Live FM, YFM, Max TV, and TV7.
All right, yes, so we're here at the Oasis Lounge and Pool Bar, and it is about the launch of Miss Malaika Ghana 2018. You have just seen our top 16 delegates, and that should tell you that the competition has just begun. Have you spotted your favorite yet? Well, Miss Malaika Ghana is proudly brought to you by UB Hair Relaxer, Glam's Makeup, Infinix, Awake Mineral Water, Carnival Liqueur, GTP, Tomric Hotel, Kenya Airways, Japan Motors, TCL Electronics, GH1 TV, and Wisconsin University.
Well, and special thanks to Taxify, Kaya Tour, City Escape Hotels, Baobab Photos, Gold Coast Restaurant, Henry's Inu Papa's Pizza, Oasis Pool and Lounge Club, Onyx, and also to our bloggers who keep us trending throughout the season, AmayaDebra.com, Konkonsat GH, Cool Peeps, Entertainment GH, Pulse GH, Event Lab, and GH Kweku.
Well, it is time for us to officially launch this beauty pageant. It's the 2018 edition, and I'd like to invite upstage the marketing manager of Chatterhouse and of Miss Malaika Ghana as well, Mr. Kafui Dobote, to officially launch Miss Malaika Ghana 2018. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Ba. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are extremely grateful you could make the time to join us here this evening as we unveil this very beautiful delegates for the 16th edition of Miss Malaika Ghana. For 16 years, we at Chatterhouse take pride in a brand that we have managed to build. It's a brand that has stood the test of time. is a brand that has integrity, gain respect, and above all, we have been consistent over the years. The Miss Malaika brand, arguably the biggest youth brand in Ghana, and we are very excited about it. You can check our social media standing and you realize that indeed. Company, we are constantly working to add more value to the Malaika brand in terms of benefits and opportunities our delegates are exposed to when they join the pageant. And this year is no exception. For the first time in pageant history in Ghana, a delegate will have the opportunity of winning seed money to start a business and social enterprise by the very kind courtesy of the British Council. And that person will also have the opportunity to travel to the UK to network with other social business owners. And for the next few weeks, the young ladies will be taking through various tasks to test their various abilities. And we are very hopeful that by the time we finish this, they would have come, left the competition better persons than they came. My advice to all delegates over the years has been, nobody, and I mean nobody, can win this competition for you. Even me, I can't promise you anything. Make sure you work hard, have fun, actually have lots of fun, make friends. These friendships will last your lifetime. This year, as always, the top five on the night will get to travel to Kenya, to Dubai by kind courtesy of Kenya Airways. The winner for this year walks away with the following, and I'm about to list the prizes. Walks away with a Miss Malaika crown, a brand new Nissan Sunny from Japan Motors, a 49-inch smart television from TCL, a brand new phone from Infinix, a scholarship for a postgraduate program at Wisconsin University, a year's supply of fabric from GTP, a year's supply of makeup from Glam's Makeup, a year's supply of products from UB, and of course, cash. Finally, before I take my seat, I would like to acknowledge and appreciate our sponsors who have been of tremendous help to us. I would like to say a big thank you to UB Hair Relaxer. They have been our partner through Glam's Makeup, Kenya Airways, Japan Motors, Turmeric Hotel for hosting the delegates. That's where they'll be lodging throughout the series. Awake Mineral Water and Carnival from Casa Preco, Infinix Phones, GTP, the British Council, and of course, GH1, our official TV partner, Taxify, Kaya Tours, the TC Electronics, TV Max and TV7, Class FM and Live FM, and of course, all our bloggers and influencers. So on that note, I would like to wish all of you the very best. May the best lady win, and with the power vested in me, I now declare the 16th edition of Miss Malaika Ghana duly and formally launched. Have a good evening.
Thank you so much, Mr. Kafui Dogote, who, by the way, is the marketing manager of Charterhouse Ghana, producers of Miss Malaika Ghana. Now, I like the fact that he stressed on the seed money that one of our delegates will be winning. And not only that, but also a postgrad scholarship from Wisconsin University. At this point, I wouldn't mind trading places with one of the ladies because I would love to win that. And I think that's why a lot of you should encourage more young ladies to take part in this prestigious pageant. Because we don't only focus on beauty. That is equally important. But intelligence, display of your talent, and a lot more is what we look out for. And we leave you better equipped than when you joined the pageant. And two of us here are clear testimonies of Miss Malaika Ghana. And so, ladies, we wish you the very best of luck. And yes, at the end, I don't like to say may the best lady win, or, you know, because I think that all of you are equally talented. And so I hope that all of you win something out of this competition. Yeah, Anita?
Well, of course, you don't only need the cash, the car, the crown, and everything that comes with it. I always say that is the icing on the cake. But if you have the cake without the icing, you can still eat your cake, right?
Yes.
Exactly. At this point, let me say a big thank you to our bloggers, Samuel Deborah, Konkonsa, GH, Cool Peeps, Entertainment, GH, Pulse, GH, Event Lab, and GH Kweku. But our 2017 queen, Pearl Nyako Mensah, will be giving us a rundown of what she's been up to and then what she looks forward to in the coming years as well. Pearl Nyako Mensah, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for her.
About a year ago, My journey towards becoming Miss Malaika 2017 began. It has been an unforgettable one, filled with fun, surprises, challenges, adventure, tears, growth, smiles, and all kinds of mixed feelings as the weeks and months pass by. All of these have given me fond memories to behold. The journey taught me to be a bold and more confident person than ever. And it has also provided me the platform to give back to society through my autism project as the reigning queen. Little did I know that it will have that much influence on the youth and the autism community, inspiring them, giving them hope, and putting smiles on their faces. Indeed, my most fulfilling experience has been the impact made on the autism community and the life-changing experience given to Royal Seeds Home through the MTN Heroes of Change. I want to thank the organizers of Miss Malaika Ghana and Charter House for giving me the opportunity to touch lives on a bigger platform. To all the amazing organizations, some of which include GCP, Renault Ghana, Verna Mineral Water, Trillium Ghana, Glam's Makeup, BB Creatives, CKC Africa, just to mention a few, the various autism centers I work with, and individuals who have passionately supported me and shared my vision, I wish to express my heartfelt gratitude. I wouldn't have achieved this much without you. To my parents, my siblings, my friends, and fans, your love, support, and encouragement kept me going throughout the journey. I'm grateful to God for his blessings and mercies upon my life. I must add that being a Malaika queen is one of the best gifts I have ever had, as it has also earned me the car, cash, coveted crown, and the prestige associated with being a reigning queen. To the top 16 delegates, congratulations to making it this far. Enjoy every moment of the competition. Make friends with one another. See one another as sisters who help one another. Put your best foot forward. And most importantly, always remember to be the better version of yourself each day. I look forward to handing over my crown to the lucky delegates. I wish you all the very best of luck. Thank you very much and have a lovely evening.
That is Miss Malaika 2017. Well, at this point, I think that we've done all we came here to do. And so it's time for you to mingle with our ladies and get to know them even more, right?
Yes, but there's an after party right here inside Club Onyx, and also always this lounge. You can hang out with your friends, chit chat, and have all the fun you can have. But before we go, my outfit for today was provided by Ajwaya Boa Clothing. Thank you so much. Makeup by Nene's Makeup Artistry and hairstyled by Hair Guru Studio Bella.
All right, and special thanks to Sima Brew for my lovely outfit, as always, and also to Faysville Beauty and to Oh My Hair and Angels Beauty Salon for taking care of my looks for tonight. And thank you all so much for joining us here at the Oasis Lounge and Pool Bar as we launched Miss Malaika Ghana 2018. My name, by the way, is Bella Mundi. And at this point, you get to interact with our ladies and get to know them more. And make sure that you choose your favorite girl and support her all through and through till the grand finale, as we look forward to the 10 top delegates who will be mounting that stage and vying for that enviable crown and the title of Miss Malaika Ghana. Thank you all so much for coming through.
So my name is Nanaya and I'm here to support Samira. She has come a long way. She wanted to do this, I mean, since level 100, and then she finally came out to do it, and by God's grace she's part of the top 16, and I'm here to support her. I wish her all the best. I pray she brings home the crown, the cash, and everything.
So I'm Vera.
I'm Abna.
Yeah, we are here to support Jela, and it's been a long way for her joining Miss Malaika. Yeah, and we are so, so glad she made it to the top 16. Yeah. We are praying for her and we trust in her that she'll win the crown. Yeah.
This is Team Anne.
We came here supporting our daughter and our friend.
Yeah.
And we are so happy seeing her come this far because we know there were a lot of people. But by God's grace, she's been able to make it this far. We are so happy. We are wishing everyone to join us. Come on board, join Team Anne. We're taking the crown, we're taking the cash, and we're taking the car definitely. And top of all, the scholarship. Osei Team Anne.
So I'm here for Nana, I'm one of the delegates, and I'm really happy and excited for her to go this far in the competition. I'm hoping she wins, and I know she will because she's exceptional.